Okay, guys, so Rope Live has been updated. Rope, of course, is our very cool face swapping software that they've had. And Rope Live is actually the newest iteration of that. They've added webcam stuff to it and all sorts of good stuff. Here's the kind of stuff you want.
42, 37, 37.
That's my face on a Bill Murray movie there. So they've gone ahead and upgraded, added some new models to it, added some cool functionalities which we didn't have before, but that also means that there's some stuff we got to download. So let's pop into this. I'm going to show you what's going on here with this, but before we do that, please go ahead, like this channel and share the video if you feel so inclined, because it does help us all out very much so. So thank you very much. Well, let's pop on over here and take a look at what we got going on here. Actually, let's pop over to here. Okay, so first let's just head on over here to the GitHub repository. So we're going to type in Rope Live GitHub. Now the original one, if you remember, was by Hillobar. The new one here is by Arjun Spin. So we're going to click like this. Okay, so this brings up our page. Now you're going to find here that nothing has really changed in the install, but you're going to need to still upgrade your repository, which we can do really easily. Okay, but there is some other stuff that we're going to have to do, and you'll scroll down here. You see it's all the same setups. We're going to get down here to where it says download the models from here. So last time, if you remember, we clicked here. This opens us up to a Microsoft OneDrive. Now the sucky thing about a Microsoft OneDrive is we cannot download multiple files at once. So we're going to have to go one by one and grab these. And here's the thing. These files have changed. So there's actually more files in here because they've added more functionality, which is a good thing, right? But it's also kind of a stink thing because we got to go through here and figure out which ones is which. Now, I will say that if you head on back on over to my Patreon site, patreon.com/cognibuild, gosh man, okay, that you'll find out over here that underneath collections, member exclusive software, you'll find that the Rope software is available for download along with a lot of other stuff. It's like $5 to get in this. There it is. And this will actually download everything for you, just do it for you, so you don't have to do all that. Okay, that aside, you go through here, and what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to click each one of these, and what you're going to do is you're going to download to, where's this at? Oh, hell, hold on just one second. Okay, what you're going to do is you're going to go to wherever you've installed your Rope, okay, and you're going to click into that folder, and you're going to put them here in this models directory, okay? You'll see them all there. Now, what I do is I count the number that are in here, and then I count the number that are in the repository here. Okay, and I just make sure that they add up. Again, if you just get the one click, you don't got to worry about all of this. But you don't have to get the one click. Just grab the models. Now, the other thing that we're going to do is this. So let's get, I'm going to get this window popped up for you here real quick. Not that one, but this one. Okay. Let's make this a little bit bigger so you can see it. Okay, now what we're going to do here is we're going to go to the folder that we've installed it into. Okay, and then just type git, G-I-T, pool. All right, now what that's going to do is if you don't have, it's just going to update your repository with what's up there. Okay, so if you've already installed Rope Live, you're just going to type git pull. It's going to pull everything down for you, okay? And then you can go through there and you can do your installations as normal. That way you don't have to re-download the you're going to have to re-download the models, but if you've already done it, they're going to stay there, but you're going to get all the new files. If you have installed the Rope Unleashed, you need to uninstall that and you need to completely reinstall Rope Live. The git pull will not work because we're coming out of two separate repositories. Okay, so Git Unleashed was off of one website, Git Live is off of another website. Okay, so they're called forks. So the original guy, Hillobar, he created Rope. Okay, and that was where we got Rope Unleashed. Now we've branched off, it's called a branch, and we're dealing with Rope Live. Okay, so if you git pull, it's going to clear you up with this directory, not with I got my fingers, not with this one. Okay, so if you have Git Rope Unleashed and you want to upgrade, get rid of Rope Unleashed and just do it all over. If you have Rope Live, you can just use the Git pool and you can download the models to make certain you have them all correct. Okay, once that's done. Okay, now another thing I'm going to say is one thing that's actually kind of helpful when you're doing this is to remove the existing virtual environment. So you can just go remove, you go conda remove dash dash name, and then I think it's just called rope, and we go dash dash all. Okay, now I'm not going to do it, but that will actually remove all of your packages, all of your dependencies. And the reason that that's good is because we want to reinstall stuff just to make sure it's all correct. A lot of times if you're having problems, you can't get your torch working, it's because you just got to get rid of the packages, start over again. Okay, this stuff, it really is procedural. So it really, one thing really does go on another. And so changing one thing up can kind of mess up a lot. But let's quick over here to the actual application and let's take a look at what's new here. So as always, you just kind of, you select your videos folder where you're going to get your inputs. This is where you get your face inputs. Okay, you go up to output folder, that's where you're going to output to. You click start and it's going to pop up everything there so that you can choose what you want. Now, I'm not going to click anything because I've got so much AI, other stuff going on that it's going to freak out the system. So down here again, of course, you find your scene, you click your find faces. Okay, you make sure swap faces is highlighted, you click face, click another face, and then you see it's going to change it up. Now they've made some changes here. What's nice, the enable audio actually works. This was not working in the other ones. Now the audio does not always match up real well with the video, but it can at least give you an idea of where you're at in the video. I would not keep it enabled while I'm doing heavy parameter work because it can bog stuff down. Now the big changes that they've made, okay, is they've condensed a lot of stuff. Okay, so first of all, they've added a whole bunch of new models in here that you can play around with. I just kind of keep them as basic and everything, but you can look through here, you can see the different stuff that they've got going. So you can play around with that, see if it makes any difference in quality. I haven't seen much difference in quality with playing with different models, but again, I'm just kind of a get it done sort of a fellow. Okay, the other thing they've done, notice swapper resolution, this was down at the bottom, is now up. This helps just kind of with your normal quality of video, so this is actually pretty important. What's nice, they put it up there at the top. I like putting stuff at 512 when I'm doing my final production, but it does slow it down, so I ain't going to use that when I'm just kind of testing stuff. I will say one of the worst things that I think that they did was down here, they moved our similarity threshold down to the bottom. This right here is one of the main things that you'll be using, because that's, if you can't find a face, it's because it's assuming it's a different face. Like for instance, down here, it wouldn't find this face. I would assume it thought it was this. I had to move the similarity threshold up, okay, before it would find that. A lot of times when you're making videos, you'll do one video and it's putting the face on multiple people because it's thinking it's the same face. By pushing the similarity threshold up, it will actually make them unique again. Now, by putting it down low, it's a pain in the butt because you got to drill down here. It's not easy necessarily to scroll here. And if you try to scroll in here, it's not going to work. And in fact, you can end up messing up other stuff. You literally have to grab that and then you've got to turn it on. I wish they hadn't have done that, but fine, whatever. It is what it is. Okay, now you can change your different, your opal, your pearl, whatnot, so you can play around with that. They've added, really what they've done with this version is they've made it so that you can really tweak a lot more, which is great. Okay, it's probably a bit more tweaking than I need to do, but it's really good. There, I said before that when they're done with this application, it's going to be awesome, and so this is part of the progression of awesomeness. You want to pull your FFmpeg quality to the left to make it as good as you can. And I'm trying to think if there's anything else up here. Really, there's your webcam stuff. Oh, your restore is a good one. You can click restore, and then what that's going to do is it's actually going to clean up the face being in there. Now, again, you can choose your different level of restore. I can't go higher than 124 or 512. So, and honestly, it gets looking a little bit goofy when you do that. The last thing they added was kind of cool, this enhanced frame. That's going to actually clean up the entire picture. Usually what I would do with these videos is I would make a video, and then what I would do is I'd send it over to Face Fusion and let Face Fusion do it. So they've added this in here. It's not perfect. It's okay. It's marching us towards a better video. Okay, so is the upgrade worth it? Abso-frickin-lutely, okay? The main thing being, you just have to make certain that you have downloaded all of the new models to get it working, okay? So you just got to make sure they count them, that they're there, okay? Again, you can go to my one click, you can get it, and she's done like that. Well, you know, it takes time to get going, but that's all you got to do, okay? You don't have to sit there and count nothing or get it going. So there you go. That's Rope Live, the update. Worth it. Do it. Get it. Make some cool stuff. Share it over on the Discord and let us know exactly what kind of stuff you're building. So I'm going to leave you here. In the meanwhile, you stay good, and we will catch you on the next side. Yo.